Harper One and Harper Audio present Seasons of Growth, a journal for well-being inspired by trees by Marcus Bridgewater. This is the author. An Invitation to Grow. Greetings and welcome to this guided journal. I created this resource to help you begin journaling or learn to journal in new ways. Journaling is the practice of taking our thoughts from pen to paper with the intention of finding clarity, organizing the mind, and learning about ourselves. This practice changed my life by providing me with an outlet when I felt trapped, confused, depressed, and unmotivated. It was also there to commemorate moments of joy and celebration, and continues to do so today. I believe it can do the same for others. In this journal, we will think of ourselves as trees growing through the different seasons, with each season representing a different combination of elements that yields unique challenges, experiences, and opportunities for learning. This will remind us that although growth requires energy and effort, it shouldn't be complicated. And when it is because of our mindset, circumstances, or external pressures. Our journal will be a log of lessons we learn from our experiences, similar to the rings of a tree that mark every year of growth. We have more in common with trees than we may think. Just as a tree has leaves, a trunk, and roots, we have a mind, body, and spirit. As we think of ourselves as trees, we will assign the major components of trees to ourselves. Our leaves correspond to our mind, our trunk corresponds to our body, and our roots correspond to our spirit. A tree's leaves, trunk, and roots adapt to the different seasons, and our mind, body, and spirit must do the same. Most important, just as a tree yearns to grow, so do we. Like a tree, we want to live in a state of wellness in which we grow to our full potential. This means having peace in our mind, balance in our body, and harmony in our spirit. I define peace as a mental state of calm and clarity. Balance is a physical state of control and stability. Harmony is the spiritual state of being composed, alert, and engaged with both ourselves and the life around us. Similar to the trees in a forest, we do not grow alone. We affect and are affected by whom we grow with and where we grow, our community and environment. The better we are as individuals, the better we contribute to those around us. Journaling helps us achieve peace, balance, and harmony because it gives us a process to monitor our growth, track our progress, and check in with ourselves. I frequently champion journaling through my work as a wellness educator, where I reach people through presentations or workshops and by sharing personal growth insights through plant metaphors on social media as Garden Marcus. Whenever I talk about journaling as a tool for self-discovery and well-being, I'm met with a variety of responses. People often ask, "What should I write about? How do I start?" Others express reluctance to journaling because they're certain it won't serve them, and many people who do try it out give up after a few entries because they don't feel rewarded. Without progress or results, why continue? Writing a single journal entry and expecting your life to turn around is like asking for fruit from a tree you planted yesterday. Growth doesn't just happen. It's a never-ending process. Something we should welcome and embrace. It requires work and a commitment to learning, and it's a process that can be observed through the growth of trees. Before a tree can fruit, it needs leaves to collect sunlight for energy, a strong trunk capable of withstanding the elements, established roots capable of absorbing water, and, most important, time to grow. At the most basic level, journaling helps us analyze and reflect on how we spend our time and energy in the world. To me, our hobbies, habits, and routines in particular create the structure of our growth. Hobbies are activities we do to feel inspired in our spirit, such as gardening or drawing, Habits are settled tendencies we have, like biting our nails or drinking tea, that can be challenging to establish or give up. And routines are processes and procedures we develop to manage the needs of the body and mind, like eating and sleeping. When we journal, we ask ourselves, am I nurturing the hobbies that give me joy? Whether that's my evening read of the news on my phone or my Thursday morning yoga class. Are my habits, like my second cup of coffee and biting my nails, serving me? Are my routines, like my wake-up time or afternoon snack, restoring my mind and body? When we journal, we take stock. We look backward in order to look forward. We channel our energy to make the best decisions for our well-being. My goal for you is to create hobbies, habits, and routines that support your growth goals for your mind, body, and spirit throughout the seasons. Remember that your journal is your own, and there are no rules to how you write, draw, or doodle in it. Whether you write in prose or bullet points, the most important factor is consistency. To get the most out of journaling, I suggest writing regularly. When I'm having a hard time, I might reach for my journal several times a day. When life is less taxing, I aim to journal every day to every few days to check in with myself and what is going on in my life. If you find yourself with writer's block, the prompts in this book can continue to guide you. As you complete these prompts, activities, and exercises, I hope you challenge yourself to think deeply about your goals, your growth, how you're tending to yourself, and how you're interacting with those around you. Revisit prompts and see how your answers change. And know that this journal can be started in any season. If it's winter, begin with the winter section. If it's summer, start with summer. Whenever you start, aim to journal through 4 consecutive seasons so you have a comprehensive understanding of your year and can reflect holistically at the end of it. Now, let's get started. Here are some introductory prompts to begin, and then you may proceed to the section covering the season you are currently experiencing. As you answer these prompts, release your inhibitions and judgments. Don't get caught up in how your responses sound or why. Just write your truth. Be honest with yourself and remember that this is a tool to support you. Grab a pen or a pencil and let's begin. 1. Who are you? 2. What is the current state of your well-being, your mental health, physical fitness, and spiritual awareness? 3. What are your goals for the coming year? 4. Why is your well-being important? 5. What is your current routine for managing your well-being? 6. What does growth mean to you? 7. Describe your growth over the past year. 8. Do you feel stunted in your growth or supported? 9. What would you like your growth to look like a year from now? Happy journaling, and here's to the seasons to come. Summer, the season of pacing and keeping tempo. Summer is the season for continuing the new growth.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.